You say in the film that bodybuilding is the greatest of all sports. Why?
It's a great sport because it is not a destructive sport. It's not like boxing where you hit each other, you know, or try to kill each other. So it's a healthy sport. It's the kind of a sport where you really can train every part of your body, and you get mentally in touch with your body very much through bodybuilding, and you get a great relationship between mind and body, which is the ideal thing, really, which is something that Plato already said, you know, sound mind, sound body. That's why I think bodybuilding is a very healthy and is the best sport.
Isn't it a kind of narcissist activity?
No, not at all. I don't see why. A lot of people think that that it has to do with narcissism, because you do a lot of your activities in front of a mirror. But the reasons why we do it in front of a mirror is the same reasons why ballet dancers do their activities in front of the mirror. It is to check out your progress, to see if there are certain things that you need in your development, and if you do the exercise correct or not. It is the only way you can check it is in the mirror.
Which is the exact meaning of the expression pumping iron? It seems rather difficult to understand.
Well, pumping iron means that you pump up the muscle with iron, which is with dumbbells, with barbells, and with all the machines. You know, with it, these are your tools to pump up the muscles, and blood flows into your muscles, and that's why we came up with that term pumping iron, pumping up the muscles with iron.
How did Bob Rafelson approach you to play in his film, Stay Hungry?
Well, he had a screen test for around 200 actors and bodybuilders or well-developed men, and I was the one who had the best screen test, and I delivered the lines the best way, and I had the right personality, the right age, and the right physical appearance, and also what he said, very good talent for acting, and so I got the job. You know, it was by accident. And since then, I loved acting, and I will continue with acting and discontinue bodybuilding.
Do you plan to make other movies?
Yes, I plan to make other films. I made so far 4 films, and I just signed a contract for 5 more films. And we will start in February.
Which kind of films?
Well, the film is called Conan, which is a film about a prehistoric character, and it's a science fiction film.
Strong, stay long, talk loud, and win the Olympia crowds.
Oh, really?
That's it. Say it, believe it, and achieve it. It's as simple as that. Schwarzenegger goes today. Evita Zane, Evita Schwarzenegger. Samir's coming on strong.
All right, right on.
The Lebanese man.
Lebanese lover.
Oh. How you doing, Kenny?
Good.
Hello, Kenny Beard, my manager. You're responsible for everything.
Feeling good?
Signs the checks, keeps you rolling.
You have the pen is mightier than a muscle in this particular case, right?
That's the gold pen.
Remember the golden rule, he who has the gold makes the rules.
Zane and Arnold in big trouble today.
Oh, I know that.
That's goddamn close. You understand how to move this on top.
Yeah.
So just, remember that.
Right, oh yeah, I will.
You remember that.
This damn thing is so close out there. They got so many great bodies in there, I've never seen so many guys come in shape in one contest.
That's right, yeah, it's a dangerous situation.
That's right.
Yeah, I picked the right year, didn't I?
Let's move today.
Yep.
Oh, gee, that light.
Check it out, Tommy. Excellent.
Nah, you look great. It's never been that ripped.
Well, I just saw something here tonight, just now, right in here, that didn't exist on stage today.
Well, with that fucking lighting out there, nothing exists. I mean, that's another story.
Good. Brutal. Massive.
that's it.
You look much better than ever, by far.
He looks better than ever.
Ripped.
Which is enough.
Oh, man. You
yeah, how can you look more than better than ever?
That's pretty hard to do. Maybe next year better than ever.
Yeah. See? But this is next year.
Yeah. You've been reading some philosophy, too, I see. I've been doing that every night now, reading philosophy.
Which is good.
It's interesting. It keeps my mind clear.
Fantastic. Confused.
Lost. What do I do now?
How long do you think it will be till we get up there?
Another hour?
About an hour to go.
For now?
Yeah.
Vielleicht sprichst du von 1, 2, 3 oder 4.
Hier?
Ja, und dann den anderen mit den neuen Armen vorne.
6.
Ja, das ist besser, glaube ich. Und du?
I would relax if I were you.
Can anybody find out how much more time it is?
We have exactly 20 minutes, okay?
To go out there?
Yes.
You can actually create a vision of what your body will look like. And then you mold your body closer and closer to that vision. And actually, you will turn this vision into reality. And it's wonderful, really, to see that happening, that you actually can see it in front of you, which I think they call the third eye, you know, where you visualize what you want to be in reality, and then you get closer and closer to that. And that's a known thing now in sports, the inner sports, they call it.
Mr. Como, how are you doing, sir?
Good face.
Good.
No, it's wrong.
Perfect.
Also, I think just the experience of being much stronger than everybody else, I think that's an unbelievable experience. You feel richer. You feel that sooner or later that you can do anything.
Thank you.
wins, huh?
I don't know. Had a good time.
No.
I'm in the best shape of my life. What can I say? I feel great. You know what I mean?
That's good. Yeah.
And when you know you put your total being, every bit of inner person into your training and into this day, you feel good no matter what. I feel good in that sense. Placing it all. You know? All I know is I'm the best I can be right now. And that's it.
We'll see you later.
Okay.
In the necklace, Mr. Billy.
No.
You want the necklace?
Everybody likes to be wanted and needed and appreciated and loved and all those things. Some people only have it in a limited way, you know, by just being loved by their family or by their children or by their brother or whatever, a wife. Some people like more than that. You know, I'm one of them. To me, it's always a great pleasure performing in front of a great audience. It really turns me on, and it's a real enjoyable thing, you know, when you see people enjoying what you do.
Schwarzenegger.
You better believe it, man. It was exactly like it used to be. I mean, I got so turned on. It brought back so many great memories.
It's amazing when you're out of it for 5 years.
You have to like learn all over again, every step. And which is a wonderful experience, of course, because it puts you right back where you belong, which is definitely not in the sky.
But here you put it together, Arnold. You put it together.
And in 2 months or 2 weeks, the last week.
2 months altogether.
Yeah.
All I wish that I could do is to have a time machine and just wind it to the front like an hour and a half. Just let me know much more.
Yeah, I can tell you right now, right? I know.
There's one class of bodybuilder and then there's your class.
What do I feel this time? Hungry. Craving some food in general. Looking forward to tomorrow. I feel good about today.
I want an ice cream soda about that big. And a pizza pie. What do you want, a bottle of wine?
I want a bottle of wine, bread, and cheese. Bottle of wine, bread, and cheese, please, right now.
How did it feel?
It felt great. It was, I have heard throughout the whole day today that it's a very close contest. And, I want to make sure when it is that close that the last minute you put everything in its... that you have. And so that's what I did. I really had my friends, psych me up and told me that to be brutal and to get into it, just like in the old days. And so that's what I try to do, to get really into it and just pose and feel the audience. And if the audience likes one pose, to stay long at that pose. If the audience didn't like another pose, to just get out of it as fast as possible, and all those things. So it was like I came closer and closer to the old days. And his last routine, so I feel really good right now. And there's one more round to go, which is the pose off with the six best, which are the six best guys. And I think that's exactly when I hit my 10.
Here are the seven finalists in numerical order. Number 2, Boyako, USA. Number 4, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Number 5, Roger Walker. Number 6, Roy Callender, Canada. Number 7, Mike Mensah, USA. Number 11, Frank Zane, USA. Number 12, Chris Dickerson, USA.
These are the 7 finalists. My good friend here, Frank Burwas, will be giving the judges their final papers. And the judges, please. Just put number 1 against your number 1 choice. Thank you, Frank.
Two days of eating. You're trained for this. Depressed? Yeah. I'm the best I can be right now.
Most people are too close to the what they're doing that they can't see themselves anymore, But I always step back and just laugh at myself because it's really, you can't take it seriously, the whole thing. It's just something that I believe we have to do certain things in order to keep us going and motivated and pick little goals and go after them and stuff like that.
Chris Dickerson, Frank Zane, Mike Mensah, Roy Callender, Roger Walker, Arnold Schwarzenegger, or Boya Ko.
You have to be able to step back out of yourself and look at it of what you're doing and laugh about it, because it's all funny, being the best built man in the world. Very funny.
I believe in Jim Beam. It's one of the most remarkable products, not only in the United States, but all over the world. People sometimes use it to get high in a bar, maybe after depression, so bad business deals or whatever. But we bodybuilders obviously use it as a high protein and high amino acid supplement. Now let's see.
How do you use that, Mr. Schwarzenegger?
We usually put it in a very sophisticated kind of
a jigger, a special jigger.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Now, it's very important that you take the right measurement here because...
I have never drank in my life.
Wait a minute.
Oh, my God. The skin is coming apart.
This is amazing.
Pump.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, do you want to get a pump? Buy something from Jim.
Fourth place goes to Boyer Cole. Third place goes to Frank Zane. Second place, Chris Dickerson. First prize, Mr. Olympia 1980, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
He has that ability to make you love him and like him and want to vote for him. Arnold has that quality of convincing you that he gives you a good feeling. When you watch Arnold, you go, wow, he's got it together. He feels good. He's in love with life. I want to be like that, too. When Arnold walks on the stage, he just puts his arms up over his head, flexes. People go crazy. They love him.
Thank you very much. I'm extremely excited about winning the seventh time the Mr. Olympia competition, and I have to be very honest that this was the highest level of competition I've ever faced in any competition in my life, and I was not aware of that. That this was it's going to be.
Leave for a while.